Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Das Academy of Science. Hypermetropia. Some people can see objects at long distances but cannot see nearby objects clearly. This type of defect in vision is called hypermetropia or farsightedness. A healthy person can see objects at all distances more than 25 centimeters clearly. But a person with hypermetropia can see objects clearly after certain distance only. Now observe the pictures whether vision is clear or blurred. If the object is at the point of least distance of distinct vision, the vision is blurred because the person of hypermetropia cannot see the nearby objects clearly. If we move the object with some distance away from the eye, still the vision is blurred. Further, if we move the object with some more distance from the eye, the vision is blurred. But after the next point, vision is clear. The point of minimum distance at which the person of hypermetropia can see the object clearly is called near point, and this near point is denoted by H. That is, in between point of least distance of distinct vision and near point, the vision is blurred. If the object is beyond near point, up to infinity, the vision is clear. That is, if the object is at near point or beyond near point, person of hypermetropia can see the objects clearly. In these cases, eye lens can form image on retina. But the person of hypermetropia cannot see the objects between the point of least distance of distinct vision and near point. In such cases, the rays coming from the nearby object after refraction through the eye lens forms image beyond retina. This is because the focal length of eye lens of the person with hypermetropia is greater than 2.27 centimeters. Now, observe the ray diagrams for the following cases. Object is at the point of least distance of distinct vision. The rays coming from the object refracts at the eye lens and forms image beyond retina. When the object is between near point and the point of least distance of distinct vision, the rays coming from the object refracts through eye lens and forms image beyond retina. Thus, if the object is at the point of least distance of distinct vision or between near point and the point of least distance of distinct vision, the image forms beyond retina, and hence the person of hypermetropia cannot see the object clearly. Now, observe the ray diagrams for the following cases. If the object is at near point, the rays coming from the object refracts at eye lens and forms image on retina. If the object is beyond near point, the rays coming from the object refracts at eye lens and forms image on retina. Thus, if the object is at near point or beyond near point, the image formed on retina, and hence the person of hypermetropia can see the object clearly. How can we correct hypermetropia? The eye lens can form clear image on the retina when the object is placed at near point or beyond near point. To correct the defect of hypermetropia when the object is at the point of least distance of distinct vision or between the near point and the point of least distance of distinct vision, we need to use a lens which forms an image of the object at near point or beyond the near point. This can be made possible only when a biconvex lens is used. Recall the ray diagram of convex lens when the object is between focus and optic center. The parallel ray to the principal axis after refraction passes through principal focus, that is F1. And the ray passing through optic center does not deviate. Since these two refracted rays are diverging rays, they cannot intersect at anywhere. So that if we extend back these two refracted rays, they converge at a point. At this point, image will form. That is, when object is placed between focus and optic center, the image formed on the same side of the object, and this is magnified and virtual erected image. Now, observe the ray diagram for correction of hypermetropia. When the object is at least distance of distinct vision, the rays coming from the object refracts at eye lens and forms image beyond retina. But when we use biconvex lens, image of the object formed at near point, and this image will act as object to the eye lens, and hence the image will form on the retina. Then the person of hypermetropia can see the object clearly. Now, let us find the focal length of the biconvex lens used to correct hypermetropia. Here, object is at the least distance of distinct vision. So, object distance is taken as 25 centimeters. But according to sign convention, it is taken as minus 25 centimeters. So, u is equal to minus 25 centimeters. By biconvex lens, image is formed at near point. So, image distance is nothing but distance between near point and lens. So, image distance is taken as small d, which is the distance to near point from the biconvex lens. So, v is equal to d. But according to sign convention, v is taken as minus d. So, object distance u is equal to minus 25 centimeters and image distance v is equal to minus d in centimeters. By lens formula, we have 1 by f is equal to 1 by v minus 1 by u. Here, u equal to minus 25 centimeters and v equal to minus d. Substituting u and v values in the above equation, we get 1 by f equal to 1 by minus d minus 1 by minus 25. That is, 1 by f equal to minus 1 by d minus of minus plus plus 1 by 25. By taking LCM, we get 1 by f equal to minus 25 plus d by 25 d, or f equal to 25 d by d minus 25. Here, f is positive, showing that it is a convex lens. So, focal length of biconvex lens which is used to correct hypermetropia is 25d by d minus 25. Thank you. If you like this video, please share and subscribe my channel, Das Academy of Science.